We are gonna go live. Yes. All right, we're live. Welcome, William. Welcome, Kenny. How are you guys doing today?
I'm great. Thanks, guys.
Doing great. Doing great. Glad to be here.
For those of you who are watching us live today, I want to wish everybody a very happy Mother's Day. I am chimed in from Texas, and it is May 12th here. And I've got with me two amazing friends of mine and my certified consultants. I figured it is time to reveal something really amazing that behind the scenes that I've been working for a while. And I have my very first two certified Chinese metaphysics practitioners here with me. And I wanted to introduce them to the world today. So I've got Dr. Kenny Chong here from Dubai joining us. And I've got William Chua here from Singapore. So hi, William. Hi, Kenny.
Hello.
Hi, everyone. Hi, everyone.
I wanted to discuss and focus today as to our personal journey with Chinese metaphysics and have some inspired conversations so that the world can understand where we come from, why we are so attracted to Chinese metaphysics, and what brings us together. But at the same time, how do we make a dent in the universe? You know, as entrepreneurs, as professionals, we are driven to contribute, to serve, but also to have a purposeful journey towards our life and professions. And we all come from different professions. I'm a university professor turned, Chinese metaphysics practitioner and entrepreneur, and I've built businesses for the last 10 years. And I know, Kenny, you have an extensive information and experience in HR industry. You have a doctorate there, and you've done great work coaching people, hiring people, firing people. Yeah. And then, William, I know you've got amazing, almost 30 years of experience building your insurance agency and coaching and mentoring and promoting people to the next level of their careers. And we all came together. It's like, you know, the universe brought us together in our last year. It was an affinity towards each other. You know, out of like 250 plus students in a class, when you're learning something and Bodzi brought us together, we were all in a professional certification program last year. And then out of those 250 students, seven of us came together and we formed our own little, tribe, if I can call it. So I want to start with some questions, if you are ready to share. So can you share with us, I'm going to start with William. William, can you share with us your journey into Chinese metaphysics and what inspired you to become a practitioner? I know you are a blown entrepreneur, you have your own business. But what brought you to Chinese metaphysics?
All right. I couldn't remember actually started from when, but it's come from many years ago. Actually, I'm quite interested in the metaphysics, especially like the 12 zodiacs. You see, because in Singapore, because I stationed in Singapore, okay, currently it's 10:14 p.m. In Singapore, during the Chinese New Year period, especially the Chinese New Year Eve, normally there will be a variety show, and then they invited some masters talking about the 12 zodiacs and how these 12 zodiacs actually affect the individual in terms of their whole year, in terms of the aspect of maybe health, wealth, career, relationship, and so on. So I was quite amazed by how they explain all these things. And there's one year when they were talking about this 12 zodiac, and apparently there's a ranking of this 12 zodiac, and my year of birth zodiac ranked the bottom three. So that, bottom three, is that so? So I was kind of, maybe this master cannot be trusted. Okay, so I go and Google, I go to a bookstore, I read up a lot of articles from different masters about the 12 zodiacs. And in the end, you know what? Yeah, apparently, it's about the same. Though it might not be exactly the bottom three, but it's in the bottom.
Wow.
So I said, that means in that particular year, I'm going to face a lot of challenges. Mm. So okay, never mind. Let's forget the whole thing. this very simple attitude. Let's forget it and then just move on, you see? And true enough, at the end of the year, I realized that there's something that actually does happen, or did happen along the way, that it proved that it's a bit true, but not totally all true, but it's a bit true. So I was thinking, should I actually go further to deep dive into and then get to know what these masters actually claim to have all these 12 zodiac in details? Then I start to learn Bazi in 2019. And I realized that whatever the masters have shared during this variety show, it's just the tip of the iceberg, in fact.
Correct.
There are so much things that you learn in the Bazi that can actually we can do and we can help ourselves to grow better and then I would say maybe conquer whatever challenges along the way.
Correct.
Yeah. So correct. From then I go on to get back to the Bazi. Then subsequently somebody actually introduced me the Qimen Dunjia. So I get to know that Qimen Dunjia is about the so-called the strategy execution. Then I was amazed by actually how this Qimen Dunjia can do. And then I spent another couple of 1 to 2 years to deep dive again. And subsequently, I move on to another three more is in the feng shui, and as well as this date selection. And of course, but last but not least is the I Ching. So that comes until today, what I am today.
Awesome. That's amazing. You know, it's great to understand that there is a tool and a modality in Chinese metaphysics called Bazi, where you can learn more about yourself. So what I'm hearing you say is that it can be an amazing tool for personal development and to figure out your strengths and weaknesses. And then Qimen Dunjia can be used to take action or strategize your like professional development plan, if I want to say it, right? So thank you, William. So I'm going to go to Kenny. Kenny, because this is great segue, because you come from human resource background and your corporate jobs have been in that field. Would you care to tell us a little bit how you see using Chinese metaphysics, especially Bazi? We're going to talk more about Bazi later on too. How have you used it, or how do you see the applications, and have you used it personally?
sure, Gagan. So as a HR professional, you know, with more than 50 years of experience, I always have interest on human behavior. You know, I'm dealing with people every day, you know, be at work and, you know, for family and so on and so forth. So for me, my journey starts, my journey on Chinese metaphysics began around 5-6 years ago. It was actually driven by the curiosity about, you know, the way traditional wisdom, you know, like Bazi can explain, you know, on personality and destiny, right? So that kind of connect with me straight away because I have a lot of interest on human behavior. So my focus is on Bazi system, which is also, you know, as you also know, that is also the four pillar destiny. It's one of the area of Chinese metaphysics. This have actually started by using the system. It actually helped me to, you know a little bit more about myself. And it's actually give me a lot of insights, right? And also with my analytical nature, right, it's also kind of give me a structured way of how, you know, I can explore human behavior, I can explore life events, I can explore a lot more of my potential, for example, and also potential of others as well. So in a nutshell, right, I was actually quite inspired by the clarity that Bazi have brought to my life, especially when facing challenging time, right? So from there, Gagan, I pursue advanced studies and I, you know, did my certification to become a part-time Bazi consultant. overall, my aim is actually to not just to help myself, but I actually to also hopefully be able to help others to understand their life path, to be more clearer and, you know, to help others, you know, as part of my profession. So I think that's in terms of how I get into the Chinese metaphysics and Bazi.
That's amazing. You know, we all came together because we were in studying Bazi professional certification together. So we are all certified in Bazi, but as you all know, that Ziwei Daoshu, Destiny Science, is my baby. You know, I've been studying Ziwei for almost 8 years, and that's how I rebranded my entire businesses to have Chinese metaphysics as the core, like the soul of all my businesses. And it's like every day you wake up, that's the first thing you do. You know, you look at your day energy, you look at your own energy, you align yourself, you look at your month, you plan your year ahead, you plan your decades ahead. And it's interesting, 2 years ago, I was in a class with Dr. Joe Yap, and he kept pushing me, Gagan, why are you not leveraging your time, money, resources? You need to have your consultants. You need to build a team. You need to do A, B, and C. And I'm like, yes, sir. Yes, sir. And then he would later on, when I would go back into classroom, he would ask me, did you do that? And I'm like, I'm working on it. So I'm very happy that it has taken me almost 2 years to get to a place to have the proper team for my clients, for my subscribers, for my followers, that it's not just me doing everything. Now I have a family with you both coming on board to serve the community and the tribe that follows me. So I'm very excited and looking forward to a prosperous journey ahead. So I'm going to move on to the next question that I have, which is kind of interesting for me, because every practitioner, even though they are certified in the same modality, has their own spin on doing the reading, spin on consultations, spin on how do they dig deeper and get to the root cause of a problem for a client, right? Whether it's karmic, whether it is a present moment, whether it's their career, whether it's their spouse, whether it's their personal issues. My biggest aha moment with learning Bazi was that I have a full bullying punishment on my destiny chart, my Bazi chart, that I never discovered. That component I didn't discover in Ziwei. So that was an amazing information for me that allowed me to take my information, my insights to the next level. So in your consultation process, Kenny, can you tell me, when you have a new client come in for a Bazi consultation or for coaching, where do you start? Like, how do you tailor your approach to meet an individual client? Because no two clients are same. It's like they have their own DNA, they have their own Bazi chart, they have their own cycles of energy. How do you tailor your approach and your knowledge in helping them solve their problem?
Right. So Gagan, I mean, for me, a consultation, it's not just about consultation. It's not just me talking. So for me, it's more of a two-way conversation. And it's also a coaching. There's a lot of coaching principles that I actually put in as well. Now, in summary, for me, a consultation, I generally start with obviously constructing the Bazi chart, you know, using their date of birth and the time of birth, right? Mm-hmm. And of course, before meeting the client, you need to do some preparation, you know, kind of understand a little bit about, you know, the energy of the chart, you know, some of the potential, some of the areas that the client might potentially look into, right? Now, the other thing is that I usually don't do general reading. You know, I don't go to the client and say that, hey, you know what, I'm going to read to you about your chart, right? So what I normally do in the same time while constructing the chart, before meeting the client, I will actually ask the client upfront three areas or three questions that they actually wanted to know more or is the most important to them, okay? So in terms of the approach, right, I like to tailor the consultation to address specific concern of the client, right? You know, whether it is related to career, relationship, personal growth, I want to provide them with a practical strategies to align with, you know, certain action that they can take, or, you know, any kind of area or any kind of specific timing that can be suggested by the power of a butter chart, right? So during that conversation, we discuss about the chart implication, right? It can be focusing on the character traits, right? It can be focusing on the potential life challenges, maybe upcoming for opportunities, you know, based on that three question that the client have actually raised, right? You're correct, Gagan. Each session, each consult or each coaching session is interactive, is very, very different, right? So I generally also allow the client to ask questions and explore, you know, various aspects of their chart along the way, right? So that gives us the opportunity to agree on the practical strategy. And the most important thing at the end of the day, at the end of the session, is to align their action with the most suitable timing, you know, and the least resistant path for them to achieve what they want. So this is my approach, Gagan.
I love the fact that the least resistant path, you know, because sometimes we want to go on a certain path and it keeps on giving you roadblocks after roadblocks after roadblocks. And I know what attracted me to Chinese metaphysics was that I could really say whether one, that path was the right path or not to pursue. Number two, what's the least resistant path and how can I speed up my ability to achieve results? Because results are very, very important to me. The two non-negotiables for me is quality and results. So in order to have those applications applied in the right way to create results is very important. And William, I want your perspective on this. Like, you know, there are a lot of misconceptions out there. You know, people think this is what Bazi is, or this could be Chinese metaphysics. So how do you address those? If you encounter those in a consultation, like, oh, I thought feng shui was this, and I thought, you know, Bazi is this, or I'm going to get this. How do you solve that kind of a misconception in a consultation?
All right. Thanks, Gagan, for the question. I do receive all this similar question, as you mentioned, that, like, example, like feng shui, they'll ask me that, oh, when do I get lucky? Or when do I get rich? You see, this is a kind of misconception that it's not when you will get rich, because it's action-based, because a lot of things are action-based. If just by merely waiting for when you will get rich, nothing will happen.
Correct.
Seriously, yeah. So in fact, in terms of whether when you become lucky, when you become rich, is equivalent to the so-called the energy together with your health and so expect. Because in certain aspects that the health and wealth is in the opposing direction. When you want to acquire wealth, you need to sacrifice your health. You see? in a way. So you can't have both health and wealth together at the peak, in the sense. Of course, for young people, when they come to me, they say, hey, I'm young, so I'm able to sacrifice my health. Which is, I think, is fine. But when for older people like me, probably health is more important than wealth. You see, So there are these kind of misconceptions that both can run together. But of course, it's related. These two are related, closely knit related. But it doesn't equal in this way. Of course, when you talk about how you're going to see this thing and the wealth and the health, is in different way of readings. Because I kind of agree with. Kenny, when the way how you actually approach the client on the readings, when a client come to me, the same thing. This is a misconception. I want to tell them that actually it's not that your partner chart tell you that you got this wealth. Definitely, you have the wealth. You need to have certain actions and to achieve the goal. It just means that this wealth in your chart means that is you have the so called higher potential acquiring the wealth.
Correct.
If there's no action, it goes to nothing. Yeah. So can you imagine there are a lot of people who born every hour, every minute, right? So that means there are a lot of people having the same partial chart. So can you imagine, why aren't they the same so-called destiny? they don't have the same results, same outcome. Why? Because their action, is different. Their location is different. The country is different. The upbringing is different. So life experience is different. So there's so many factors actually come into the effect of what is going to be in the future.
Yeah.
So it's more towards, to me, I see is the action. The action you're going to do. So for Bazi, what we see is that when the energy is favorable to you, you grab it and then do more to achieve it. When the energy is not so good at a point of time, you just avoid it or do less on certain aspects.
Correct.
So these are the misconceptions people thought that, whenever I see a wealth, I will get rich easily. It's not that way.
It's a potential. It's a potentiality.
Exactly.
And I like the fact that you address those misconceptions in your consultations. And it's an aha moment for a lot of people to understand that, yes, you can have health and wealth, but you have a limit to that. And in my perspective, wealth is good, money is good and required and needed in order to have your best life possible. But without health, what are you going to do with the wealth? And I think there are different forms of wealth. Which one are you focusing on? I think having good health is the biggest wealth. Having good relationships is another kind of wealth. Having children who love you, parents who love you, is another form of wealth. Having a tribe that loves you is another form of wealth. So money is just one component, but it's not everything. But I agree that you need money also. So aligning your energy, your actions with the right timing is amazing. And I love the fact that we all use, date selection to figure those components out for ourselves. In advance, on a weekly basis, monthly basis, quarterly basis, and we do the same for our clients. And it's an amazing feeling knowing when to take action and when to just be quiet. It's like when to ebb and when to flow. There is a Chinese proverb, I think I read about it, and that was like my starting point with Chinese metaphysics. I was reading a book, a Ziwei Daoshu book, about 7-8 years ago. And it says, success is 30% abilities, 70% yun qi. Now, you know what yun qi is. It's a Chinese word. I didn't know what it was, so I had to kind of go learn and dig deep. Yun is the environment and qi is your energy, your life force energy. So just a little dissection of that proverb was your talents, your abilities, your skills is only 30% of your success. 70% is the environment and your energy. So if you can learn to tap into yun qi and improve that, your environment, both inside and outside, and align your energy to the right timing, you can have better success in life. And the definition of success is different for you both and for me, but I think we all come together because we do believe in that affinity that success is not all about money. It is about health and relationships and everything together. So how do you incorporate Chinese metaphysics into your own daily life? And have you personally benefited it? William, I'll start with you. I know you've got a very, very heartwarming story that you shared with me. I would love for you to touch a little bit about it. How has it benefited you personally? And what's that core why that you do this?
Okay. In fact, actually, I don't practice daily. I rather practice monthly and annually. Because I am a person that believed in my own action and my own decision.
Okay.
However, I still need a so-called a monthly focus or forecast to know that what is the monthly energy that comes into my life that actually will affect my decision or even my action or my thinking or even my emotion. See? So by doing all this, the monthly forecast or even yearly forecast, I will know actually what is upcoming things I will face. Then I'm able to actually handle all these aspects in a good shape, right? But apart from doing all these things monthly, okay, or even annually, there are still some other challenges that just come in out of a sudden.
Yeah.
In personally, I do have one big challenge for myself, is about my son. He's autistic. Yeah. So before I learned all this metaphysics in 2019, I have sent him to all different type of so-called courses to get him into I would say in a state of better. I cannot use the word better because in definition of this autism, it would not be so-called recover in a way.
Correct.
But I want it to become better. Okay. Mm. Better in the sense that so that he can able to take care of himself.
Correct. Correct.
Yeah. So but I was thinking of besides all these courses actually I've been sending him to, what are the things actually I can get him or help him? This is part of the reason I came into this metaphysics. Mm. Yeah. By coming to this metaphysics, I start to know that from the budget chart, I get to know what kind of his characteristic he is, and what is his strength and weaknesses, and what is actually his the path that he's going to go to in the future. From there, I can actually get him along, okay? From there until maybe the day I'm gone, okay? Hopefully one day he can pick up all these small little things or all this knowledge he actually has, he can move on his own. So that is one of my aim that actually I come into this metaphysics.
So you've personally experienced progress, taking tiny little actions using Chinese metaphysics with your son who is on the spectrum, and it has helped him on his regular progress towards managing his own life by himself. So
yes.
Thank you for sharing that, because we all have that little something special that connects to our heart that brought us together to Chinese metaphysics. And I have a similar journey. I was a seeker too, trying to solve my relationship problems for like decade, trying to keep on learning, like how can I solve like personality assessments, professional development, talent development, everything. But it all came together like an open book. Like, somebody gave me an operating manual, for my own life through Chinese metaphysics, destiny science. So thank you for sharing that story, William. I appreciate that. What advice would you guys, both of you, and you both could have different advice, because you're both different professionals, come from different backgrounds, you live in different countries. So what advice would you give to beginners? Like how would they benefit from doing a Bazi reading? Like, can you tell me, somebody who's totally new, who's watching this live stream or the recording later on, and they are like curious about Bazi, how would Bazi benefit them?
Kenny.
Kenny, you go first.
Let me start for you.
All right, so. Okay, for me, in terms of for the beginners or for people who actually watch this this session, I would say the most important thing is to have an open mind and a growth mindset, right? And for me, it's like it's like the parachute, right? You need to open it in order for it to open. Okay.
Yeah.
So and also I would say that for those who are interested in Bazi, right, I recommend it. That start from the foundation, understand a little bit of the core principle and in application where you can use this. I think that a lot of time, people starting to learn, you need to be able to know where you can actually apply it, right? Yes,
correct.
Of course, learning about the elements, the animal sign, and how they interact with each other, and how does it actually influence your life? And it will be very, very important. And start with yourself, right? If you start applying it to yourself, you will see the progress, you will see the changes, and it will be able to lead you to take certain action, right? So for me, the learning comes from me apply the knowledge that I've used, and then it coincide and align with the timing and the action that will help me in what I would like to achieve, right? Other than that, as I think for beginners, they can actually seek for consultation, you know, start a butter consultation, has a comprehensive analysis of, you know, their own chart, and that will actually help to introduce them to the practical introduction of the butter concept, right? And you know, other than that, obviously, you know, you can read books, you can attend workshop from experienced practitioner, and have a deeper appreciation, right? So well, of course, you know, you can always get all this information from, you know, gagansarkaria.com. you know, we have tons of information about bazi, and I think that is where I think for a beginner should begin with.
Well, thank you. I know these days everybody wants to get a promotion in their career if they are in a job environment, or they want to grow their business if they're entrepreneurs or small business owners. So they want all more money. Like, when can I go to the next level? So William, with your experience coaching and mentoring like teams and, you know, a lot of people who want to have their own insurance agency, you know, so they, how do you see from a beginner perspective when somebody comes, what advice would you give them? How can they incorporate what you see in their bazi chart? Like, how do you begin with that? If somebody does have no idea about bazi and they want a consultation, or they want you to mentor them so that they could advance, how would you use the principles of bazi?
Okay. First of all, I think the individual need to have a very clear mind that what he's lacking of. With different people, different strength.
Correct.
Right? Yeah. Some people, they are very good in training. If the person is going to grow his business, okay, there are different aspects in running a business, like running like agencies. Okay, running an agency, you need to know how to train. Yeah. You need to know how to recruit. You need to recruit young people, or even not really young people. You need to learn how to coach, and now you need to learn how to mentor, and of course you need to know how to so-called the in the way guiding their so-called their own personal issue, because everybody come to insurance or going setting up a business, they have their proper personal reason and also personal problems.
Correct.
Yeah, the challenges they do have. So they need to know very well their strengths and weaknesses before they can actually move on to what they want to do, including whether do they have the required knowledge on how to run the business or how to run an agency, right? Yeah. So through this coaching, we will see the strength and weakness of this person. Then we start to actually get this person into a program or something like that to upgrade himself or herself to the direction that the person wants. It really depends on the person individually, because different, as I say, different people, different strength.
Correct.
Yeah.
I have noticed with my own experience coaching people, especially, so most people, my clients that I attract, my ideal clients, they are entrepreneurs or small business owners, or they are executives with like 30, 40 years of experience, and now they want to kind of transition over to having a side gig where their core purpose is to have a legacy, you know? So I know bazi consultation does miraculous, you know, findings for people to have their aha moments, like, oh, this was it. Even though you know yourself, you've done a lot of personal development work, but there are certain things that destiny science modalities, Chinese metaphysics, can reveal to people that they have never seen it. Like, it was either a blind spot, or they knew it, but they never embraced it, you know? And those little tweaks, I think, that bazi can provide is very, very important for people to go to the next level. So thank you for sharing that process with me. I think it's time for me to switch a little bit gears here, and I want to ask, like, what is your, like, for me, Ziwei Daoshu is my first step. Like, that's where I go by default, you know? Oh, I want to plot a Ziwei Daoshu chart. I want to look at their decade cycle, their energies, like where the clash is, what is happening, where is the opportunity for them to grow. What is your modality? Because we are all trained in multiple modalities in Chinese metaphysics. So, William, what is your go-to modality?
My go-to is, of course, the first one I use is Bazi.
Bazi, okay.
Yeah, Bazi. Because Bazi to me is a very basic, minimum things you should know about your own character.
Correct.
Before you're moving on to other areas. Because you need to know what you can do or what are the potential strengths that you have, which you probably you don't even know.
Yeah.
This is very important. And we can build on this strength, and then actually you can do well in any other areas that you want to do.
Got it. And Kenny, which one is your modality, like your go-to? Like, where do you go?
I kind of agree with William as well. My modality is obviously start with Bazi, because the awareness needs to be there. So for me, Bazi allowed me to construct a detailed life map of myself, right? So by knowing the life map, right, and it will help you to actually map out what are some of the areas that you would like to achieve and the timing and the opportunities that has actually indicated in the chart. It helps you to give you the self-awareness. Now, once you have that life map done, then, you know, you can actually build more of it with the spiritual development, for example, like Qi, with other schools as well, like Feng Shui, which is external energy, and of course, with Jiwei Daosu, for example. So for me, starting from Bazi is to create the self-awareness, and then, you know, once you have your life map, you can expand it to other schools and you can apply it concurrently together with your life map from Bazi.
That's amazing. So I know, Kenny, you are a certified coach as well. Mm. And you've done coaching and mentoring in your career, and so has William. So when you have somebody who starts with a Bazi reading and then they want the next steps, do you coach them or do you do some other modality, or like William touched on strategic execution, how to take actions using Qimen? So do you coach Kenny using Bazi or you layered it with different modalities?
Yeah. Sorry, maybe let me start first.
Yeah,
sure.
Don't mind. For me, I don't have any fixed method of doing it. It depends on the area of concern the clients have, okay? But usually, as I just mentioned, I started with Bazi. But I may go into Qimen if needed, depends on the person's questions. And eventually, I will go to Feng Shui even, or even deep selection. Yeah. Because the whole concept to me, as whole, it could comprises everything, all these four big items. Yeah, but mainly it's using the Bazi to know everything. Then maybe the treatment part, we'll talk about what deity that the person is actually inclined to, right? Mm-hmm. And then he and she can manifest to the deity to achieve something special. Then you can use the feng shui or the area of the house or the energy to boost up the energy.
Correct.
And then last but not least, choose a good date for the person to activate something.
Everything all. Yeah, I love it. Thank you, William. That's amazing. Kenny, what about you? You use only Bazi?
I use others as well. It really depends on the needs of the client at the end of the day. So I have clients who came to me, you know, for career coaching, for life coaching, for relationship coaching, you know, for many, many different things, right? So for example, just to give you an example, I have clients who actually come to me, you know, seeking for spiritual awareness, right? So when it's spiritual awareness, other than doing Bazi, you know, I would obviously layer it with the human manifestation, you know, helping them to identify, you know, their guardian of destiny, and right. then share with them, you know, the direction where they can actually utilize and back to for the manifestation, and share with them a little bit on the technique of manifestation to help them to build, you know, the internal spiritual energy. That's one. Sometimes I also have a client who came to me saying that, you know what, they are hybrid, so they work hybrid, they go into different place to work, or, you know, in today's world they do a lot of hybrid working. Sometimes they work at home, sometimes they work at office and stuff like that. So they were asking me, like, you know, where would be the best place to work? Where would be the best direction for them to tap into? Then, you know, on top of the bazi consult and coaching you, I will share with them a little bit about feng shui as well, right? You know, these are your favorable direction that you should focus on. Yeah. And these are your least favorable. If you have a meeting, it would be good that if you're at home, you know, you should face to this particular direction because it is favorable to you and so on. So yeah. this, you know, other than bazi, yes, there are qi men and feng shui that I actually layer in, and that it helps the client to take action. Because at the end of the day, right, although that, you know, bazi can help you to identify, you know, certain trends, potential, right, I think the most important thing is to empower the client with the knowledge so that they can make informed decision, and then and the most important thing is to take action, right? So sometimes layering different schools of Chinese metaphysics like feng shui and qi men can help them actually to take the action, even more precise action. And obviously with the date selection as well, sometimes I do select certain date for them to start certain business or to start certain activities. That gives them that specific, the specific details, like when, how, what to do, on top of the bazi, you know, the trends and the potential that we have shared with them. Yeah. So I think, you know, I agree with William. It really depends on the needs of the client.
I agree with both of you, because the starting point becomes destiny science modality, whether it's bazi or Ziwei for me, and then you layer it to go further. So, well, thank you so much. I think we've done a good job in introducing and sharing your heart and soul and your passion to the community today. So I appreciate you guys chiming in at a very late hour, William, in Singapore right now. It's pretty late. And for you also, it's you're ending your day in Dubai, Kenny. So thank you so much for chiming in, and we will be doing this more. So stay tuned for the next one whenever we have. William, all the best. Excuse me. All the best. You're going to Tibet, right? For your
Yeah, I'm going to Tibet soon.
Yes. All right. Keep us tuned. Send us some videos on Telegram. And for those of you, I would encourage everybody to go subscribe and like our video on YouTube. Subscribe to our channel. We have a Telegram channel as well. So if you guys can subscribe and follow us, that will be amazing. So thank you for watching, and thank you for being here, William and Kenny. I appreciate you guys. All the best. See you soon.
Thanks, Gagan.
All right. Bye-bye. Thank you.
Take care.